What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we are going to be talking about why Black girls are insecure. Before we get this video started, I have to give a special shout out to my sponsor, ashkicken.com, okay? They have the best home fragrance and health and beauty products. They are made with 100% natural quality ingredients, and they're handcrafted with your family in mind. Not to mention, they have like anything you can think of. Like, I'm telling y'all, like everything, okay? From body butters to hair moisturizers, African black soap, scented candles, incense sticks, and much more. And they're priced just right for you. Treat your home and your body with Ash Kicken products. Visit ashkicken.com. That's ashkicken.com. Or you can visit the link in my description box or in the pinned comment down below. And use my coupon code THEMELLE, THEEMLLE, at checkout for 15% off your order today. Now, I am sick and tired of people coming to my comment section and
like, oh my god, you black girls, this, you black girls, that, y'all never gonna amount to nothing.
That's why y'all is, that's, oh my god, I just be like, yo, why? Like, yo, I don't understand why it's so hard to understand our frustrations, our struggles, our heartache, our disappointments, and the list goes on, okay? Now, I do not believe in the woe is me attitude, and I do not believe that black women exhibit a woe is me attitude, okay? We are the shit, we are bomb, and we keep our heads up through all of the bullshit that people put us through, okay? So these are legit the reasons I believe black women are insecure. Now, before we get into this, comment down below, why do you think black women are insecure? Or if you are insecure or were once insecure or know anyone who is insecure, let me know down in the comment section below, what is the reason behind this? I would like to give a huge special shout out to my sponsor at Car Marshall. If you need a new car, a used car, any car, make sure you head to carmarshall.com and they will definitely get you the best price. And the best thing is, they will do all the negotiating for you. You don't have to sit through a long process. Just head down to the link down in my description box or in my pinned comment down below to get started today. Now, don't get me wrong, everyone has insecurities, but having an insecurity and being insecure is not the same thing, okay? Now, let's just get that straight before we get started, okay? Now, the first thing I would have to say that I observed, especially with me when I was insecure, especially growing up, was hair. Now, I went natural 2013, right before I started undergrad, okay? And it was because I realized that personally, I had an obsession with length. For me, it wasn't really so much texture. I never really like hated my kinks or anything like that. I just wanted to like fit in, and I wanted to have long hair like everyone else. Like, everyone around me had really long hair, and I had long hair too, but I couldn't see the length because my hair was kinky. So I really wanted to perm my hair, but my mom wouldn't let me perm my hair. So my godmother permed my hair, even though I didn't ask her, but she was one of those, you know,
creamy crack, I love it,
let's do it type of people. So when she insinuated,
oh my god, we should perm your hair,
I was like, yes, sis, yes. So you know we did it, whatever. I stayed relaxed from, let's see, I was about probably 12 13, and I cut it all off, I believe, when I was 18. So yeah, I stayed relaxed for the remainder of, I believe, middle school into high school, and then, like I said, when I got to college, I cut it off. And it wasn't up until recently when I realized, like, we are really indoctrined to believe that our hair is not good. We're indoctrined to believe that our hair is not done when it's in its natural state. Think about it. Every time you had a wedding, every time school's opening, every single time you got, like, somewhere to be that's important, and your hair is out, you know, say you're wearing it in an afro, say it's just in braids, you know, there's no weave, no nothing, no twist out, no nothing, your first inclination or someone else's inclination to you is when you're gonna get your hair done. Are you gonna do your hair? When you gonna get a new sewing? When you gonna get a new wig? When you going to, like, you ever thought about that? And I had to think about it the other day. I was like, oh shit. I never thought about it. Cause I like, for some reason it just triggered in my mind. I'm like, yo, we've really been indoctrinated to believe that when our hair is not like in a weave or freshly permed, well, I should say relaxed, but you know what I mean. If our hair is not freshly relaxed, if our hair is not like in something that's not in its natural state, it's not done. And that definitely does create an insecurity within a lot of Black women, because with a lot of women in general, hair is everything. That's for women across the board, no matter the race, ethnicity, culture, whatever. Hair is very important for a lot of women. So it's like, when we're younger, we're basically like already instilled with the fact that our hair is no good. And then it forces us to look at the rest of us. So that brings me to my next point, features. Now, this one is very subconscious, just like the hair thing. But then again, I have had a lot of friends tell me that they don't like their eyes because they're too big. They don't like their nose, their lips, because they're too big. And as we know, many of us know that big lips, big eyes, big nose are usually attributed or associated with Black culture. Not all the time though, because we definitely all come in different shapes, colors, and sizes. Okay, I'm not saying that only Black people have big eyes, big noses, big lips, but you understand. Okay, so what happens is as we grow up, and I'm not sure how boys work because I'm not a boy and I don't have a son or whatever, but as females, we start to look at ourselves a lot, especially when we get to that age of, you know, puberty and then junior high school, blase, blase, and we start to look at other people and compare ourselves to them. So we may look at an Instagram model and be like, oh wow, she's so beautiful, but it's because, you know, her features look different than mine. You know, her nose is pointier, or her lips are a little bit bigger than mine, or a little bit smaller than mine. Her forehead is a lot wider than mine, or a lot smaller than mine. You know, it's just like little minute things. And sometimes you may not say it out loud, but it just lingers in the back of your head. And sometimes it gets to a point where it does create an insecurity. And with that being said, society plays a large part in the insecurities of Black women. Because even though nowadays we have a lot of Black women in the forefront, actually that's a lie, there's not enough, but there's more than there was before, okay? There's more than there were before. But even that there are more Black women at the forefront of certain things, when you look at them, they're not completely the average looking, or the average, or they do not relate to the average Black woman. They're either racially ambiguous, or have very Eurocentric features, or have very loose textured hair. So it's like, when a little Black girl or an insecure Black woman sees all of these Black women in the forefront, it's like, yay, they're Black, but it's like, but they don't look like me. They don't have the same kinky hair. They don't have the same big lips. They don't have the same big hips. You feel me?
Black roles matter because you can't be it if you can't see it.
When we don't see ourselves as flawed, interesting, imperfect characters, it's a way of sort of giving easily digestible images of Black people to broad audiences.
The little girl and boy watching us on that TV need to see us to know this guy is not even the limit, and that they are worthy and capable of anything and everything, but they'll never know it if they don't see it.
So it ends up being, okay, they're pretty. Am I pretty? Everyone thinks they're pretty, but where's my type of pretty? A lot of this does start off as a kid, you know, when you think about like the Barbie dolls, the magazines, television shows, society around us just form what it is that is acceptable. It seems to form what it is that is supposed to look good. And when it comes to Black women, it's like they literally always put the same black woman in the front of stuff. Like, it's always the same type of black woman, the same black woman itself, the same. Like, have you ever noticed how redundant it is? Like, when it comes to black men, you see all types of different black men on TV. Light skin, dark skin, you know, loose hair, kinky hair, all types of shit. But when it comes to black women, you literally only see one type of black woman. So over time, it starts to manifest in your mind. Like, am I not good enough? Am I, like, not the ideal black woman? Society has definitely shaped what a black woman should be, or what a black woman should look like to black women, and that's like extremely disheartening. Now, with that being said, there does come the insecurities brought on by men. Now, this can be men in your family, such as your father, or just men around you that you're interested in, who are, for whatever reason, not interested in you. Now, I am a firm believer that you should not be doing shit for no man, okay? You are you, and whoever loves you for you, and that's it. If they want to be with you, they're going to be with you. If they don't want to be with you, they're not going to be with you. Don't ever change yourself for no man. However, in many cultures that are not American cultures, such as Caribbean cultures or African cultures, a lot of them do rely on men. A lot of them do, you know, like they I'm not gonna say they live for men, but it's part of their culture to attract a very good suitor. So from the time that they are young, they are being basically molded in a sense. Everything they do, everything they say, the way they carry themselves is typically for a man. And if it's not right, most of the time their fathers, their brothers, or any other man in their family will call them out on it and tell them that it is wrong. Tell them that it is not okay. Tell them that they need to fix it. So it becomes a thing where it's like, okay, well, this man doesn't think I'm good enough. This man says this. This man does that. I'm not gonna find a good enough man if I don't change myself to be, you know, the perfect woman for this man. And a lot of that does come from culture. And it really does suck that a lot of women have to go through that type of treatment, but it does happen. Another big issue that makes black women insecure is body image. Now, as you guys know, we tend to be a little bit thicker. And I know there's going to be people that be like, oh my God, it's because of what y'all eat. No. Genetically, black women are a lot more curvier than a lot of other races of women. That's just a thing, okay? Now it's in, okay? Having a big butt, having a boobs and a small little waist, that is in. That is the new trend. Black women were born that trend. It just became popular. When I was growing up, girls were made fun of for having a big butt. Like, dudes would really, well, boys would really sit there like, oh my God, your butt's so big, ew. Like, they used to really make fun of black girls, like, for having big butts or big boobs. And, you know, a lot of us do mature faster, you know. Some of it is genetic, some of it is, you know, the food we eat, the hormones and the chicken and the milk and all of that. But in general, a lot of us did mature faster. Like, I had boobs at like 11, 12. So it was funny because it's like, I will never forget, like, guys always used to poke fun at me like, oh my God, why are your boobs so big? And it's just funny because it's like, now, like, look at y'all. Like, the same ones that was making fun of my boobs, y'all in my DM though. Let me stop, but y'all get the point. The point is, we were born the new trend that is now, like, the it thing. Everybody want the boobs. Everybody want the butt. Everybody want to be thicker. Everyone want to gain weight. And it's just like, okay, like, but we were born this standard. A lot of us are made to feel insecure about our bodies. Now, I guess it's a lot more acceptable. It's not that bad. But for those of you who are like my age, I'm 24 and older, you guys can remember the time where it was like, oh, you too big. Oh, you fat. Da 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 da. You this just because you had a big butt or some big titties or whatever. So, that's definitely something to reflect upon. Another big thing is definitely friends, okay? Now, this kind of ties in with the whole situation of, you know, comparing yourself to people that you see in the media. but it's a tad bit different. Now, as you guys know, we all have friends, especially females. If our life don't revolve around a nigga, it revolves around friends, okay? That's why I revolved my life around YouTube, because men ain't shit and friends ain't shit. But I digress, okay? Now, the thing is with friends is I've seen a lot of you guys send me these advice videos. You guys always ask me, like, oh my God, my friend this, my friend that. And I feel like a lot of you do compare yourselves to your friends, okay? A lot of women in general, this is not even just a black woman thing. This is a woman thing. Women definitely compare themselves to their friends. And sometimes, depending on where you live at, this can be a good or a bad thing. Like, realistically, if you live in a predominantly white area and you're hanging around white girls, you're gonna be comparing yourself to white girls, and that's just dumb because you're not white. So it's like you may feel inadequate because they're white and you're black. Maybe you might feel superior because you're black and they're white. Who knows? But a lot of times I've seen it where, you know, the black girl feels that they're not as wanted. You know, they go out with their white friends or their friends that are lighter skin and they don't get as much attention. Dudes pay the white girl more attention. Dudes pay the light skin girls more attention, or the girl with the looser texture hair more attention, you know, stuff like that. So being around a certain group of friends can definitely make you feel insecure. And sometimes it's not the friend's intention, but keep in mind that if you are feeling this way, if you do feel insecure, if you do feel bad around your friends, I'm not gonna say, oh, cut your friends off, but I would say try to find friends you can relate to more. And if your friends do know, like if they know for a fact that you're struggling with this, make sure that they're trying to help you through it. If they know damn well you feel some type of way that you're not getting talk to when you guys go out, if they know that you feel some type of way about the way you look compared to them or whatever, and they're not trying to help you cope with it as a friend, those are some shitty friends and you should definitely drop them. Friends are supposed to be there for you no matter what. They're supposed to comfort you, they're supposed to reassure you, and they're supposed to boost your confidence at all times. Therefore, if they are part of the reason why you feel insecure, if they are just like not really aiding in the situation, like rubbing it in your face, like, oh my God, da-da-da, like me, da-da-da. But it's like, that's the same dude that you like, and they know that you wanted that dude. Stuff like that, you shouldn't be around that friend group. Code switching. Now, this is different. And I actually just thought about this recently. Now, if you guys do not know what code switching is, it's the fact that I can talk like this and then I can talk like that. Now, code switching is something most black people do, okay? If not, I would say all, but some people don't. Like, personally, I only code switch when I feel like it's necessary, but 9 times out of 10, I talk the same everywhere. Code switching is basically when you switch the way you talk or the way you behave or the way you present yourself to different groups of people. So when you're around a certain group, you act a certain way. When you're around another group, clearly, if I'm not about to go to class talking the same way I talk in the hood, you feel me? That's basically what code switching is. Now, the reason this may make anyone insecure, honestly, especially a black person insecure, is because eventually you end up losing yourself, and sometimes you could code switch to the point where you don't know who you are anymore. Afraid to be you. You're afraid to bring out your personality. You're afraid to be who you truly are. Now, a lot of people may be like, oh, well, not all of us are hood, not all of us are ghetto, not all of us talk like that. I'm not saying that, but there's a lot of us who do. Okay, there's a lot of us who are from the hood, and that's just how we talk. There's a lot of us who are from the hills, and that's just how they talk. You feel me? So it's just like to have to code switch, like, okay, oh, well, I'm around my hood friends, let me talk like this. Or to be like, oh, I'm around my hill friends, let me talk like that. That's a problem. And it makes you sometimes feel like, okay, not only is it that I don't know who I am, but it's like who I am is not good enough for anywhere that I go. So that's definitely something to be mindful of when it comes to insecurities of black women. Another huge one is your parents. Now, a lot of people that I know have told me that their parents are definitely their first bullies. And I definitely can't relate, but I do have a lot of friends that have really mean parents, and I've witnessed their parents being extremely mean to them. And it's really sad to think about it, that people are like that fucked up. Your parents sometimes are your worst critics. They will tell you that you are ugly, you are dirty, you are this, that, and the third. And a lot of you guys always comment on my videos about how mean your parents are to you, how condescending they are to you, the mean things they've said, the things that they've expressed to you regarding the way you look, the way you act, your career choices, your life choices, your love choices, stuff like that. So it's like, that can definitely make you feel insecure, because it's like, okay, well, you guys made me. And you guys think I'm ugly, you guys think I'm inadequate, you guys don't think I'm a good enough daughter for you. And that's definitely something that can mess with someone's psyche. And sometimes it can even like seep into that woman and raising her own family. And sometimes she will become toxic to her own husband or her own wife or her own kids. And that brings me to my next point, having children in a family. Now, we all know that our bodies, our lives, our mentalities all change when we have a child, okay? Everything changes. Maybe you have saggy skin. Maybe you develop a mental illness. Maybe you are just stressed the hell out. Maybe you do not feel desirable anymore now that you've had this kid with this person. These are all reasons that a lot of Black women become insecure later on in life. Sometimes life can be going really, really well, and then you have a family and boom, you're miserable as shit. Okay, because you know you just don't feel loved, you don't feel sexy, you don't feel this, you don't feel that. And that plays a huge part in a lot of people's insecurities. My final point is, final observation when it comes to why Black women are insecure is career. Now, a lot of us can attest that, you know, a lot of Black women, we out here. We are one of the most educated groups in America. Kudos to us, okay? Rounds of applause. And with that being said, we are getting higher paying jobs. We are moving up in the workforces. And sometimes that can be a very scary thing. And again, going back to the comparisons situation, we will compare ourselves to other people. We will make it as if, like, some of us will actually psych ourselves out to the point where it's like we feel like we are not as good as our coworkers. Or some of us, which, you know, we can, maybe all of us can agree, we get the most work to do and we're not compensated for all the work we do. We get penalized for things that other people don't get penalized for, such as hair, wardrobe, body image in the workplace. We will get underpaid. You know, a Black man or a white man will come in and he'll get paid more than you, or Sally will get a raise and you've been working near longer than her. It's a plethora of different scenarios, situations, and problems that really do arise in this type of situation. And to be completely honest with you, I've definitely went through it. That's part of the reason I stopped working a 9-to-5. Like, I wouldn't mind having another 9-to-5 if it was like completely social media based. However, like, there are way too many jobs that I've had where it's like I always felt like I was comparing myself to people, and I didn't like that. I always felt like I was in a race, and I've never been a person to compete with anyone. Like, I compete with myself, okay? And that's for all y'all listening to. You compete with yourself, okay? That's all you gotta compete with. You don't compete with nobody. But like I said, I just always felt like I was like not being paid enough, getting overworked, and I just didn't feel adequate to my coworkers. So yeah, that's definitely something that made me harbor like a subconscious like insecurity. But yeah, like I said, that's why I started working for myself, because I ain't had time for that shit. But yeah, let me know down in the comment section below. Are you insecure? Have you been insecure? Do you know anyone who's insecure? Why? And how do you or that person dealt with it? Because I'd love to know down in the comment section below. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time.